Alright, so in this video we've got one foot pretty much created. It's currently in component mode, so I'm going to right click on it and return to object mode. There's my foot. Well, what I want to do now is I want to make a duplicate of this, and I want to make this foot smoother as well. Before I do any of that though, in my channel box, look at all of these inputs which are stacked up. This is my history for creating these objects. And I want to get rid of this. I don't want this history to keep piling up. So I'm going to go to Edit, Delete All by Type, History, and you'll see that will get removed out. I also want to create a little bit of a rounder form for this right now. The square shape honestly just doesn't do it for me. To soften this out, I'm going to go to Mesh and choose Smooth, which is the fifth option down. Doing so actually creates a nice little rounded form for me. And I can take it, just move it back up a little bit so we don't see the top part. I think we've got a pretty nice looking little leg. If you don't want to smooth it, but you don't want it to also look angular still, you can see there's a very sort of faceted look to it. One way to soften it without smoothing it is to go to Normals and choose Soften Edge. And that just softens each one of the edges. It'll sometimes create some weird shading on a very low poly model like you see here, but could start to take away some of that disco ball look that a polygon model has by default. But like I said, I want to actually keep this smooth, so I'm going to smooth it, move it up. I've actually created new inputs, so let's actually go back in again and delete my history. Well, I want to mirror this foot over, so just like any other technique, I've got to go and modify, freeze my transformations, modify, reset my transformations to send the pivot point back to the center, and then edit, duplicate special, which is Control-Shift-D. And there's my other foot. Now right now both of these feet are overlapping, and normally that would be a problem, except for you can see here in my toy, they're actually just positioned in different spaces. And one of the final things we're going to do is actually rotate the body of the chicken just a little bit. So let's take this foot and push it back and rotate it out just a little bit. You'll notice the position that it rotates, however, is based off of this low outside of the foot position. If you want to rotate it based on the actual position of the foot itself, just go to Modify and choose Center Pivot first, and then rotate it. And you'll have a pretty nice looking rotation value. So now I think those feet are behaving a little bit nicer for me. Well, we've got just a few things left to do. I want to come back into my hypergraph, and I want to name my feet. Polycube 1, well, let me rename this L foot for left foot. And Polycube 2, I'll rename that R foot for right foot. I'll select both, use my middle mouse button to drag that right onto chicken toy. Now I've got it added to the group. Last thing I really need to do is create that beak. And remember, I'm not creating the eye because I feel that that's just painted on. That's just texture. And I'm not creating the sort of feather pattern because, again, that would be a texture bump map or something later on. Now that I look at my tail, you know what? I want that to be pulled upwards also. There we go. I don't know why I didn't have that before. Well, what we're going to do here with the beak is I'm, again, going to start off with a cube. I'll move it up, position it right in front of the face. There we go. That's a perfect looking beak. Little cube sticking out front. Well, what I'm going to do, I want to actually try and get, there's a little groove, I know it's very subtle and might not show up in the video, but there's a little groove between the upper and lower beak. And I want to actually establish that. To do this, I'm going to get the Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool, and cut twice right through the center. I also want to take the tip of this. I'll right-click and choose Vertex. Before I go any further, I want to scale this in as well. And take the really sort of front tip part and move that out. I can grab the vertices on either side, scale these out a little bit to round them out. And again, I'm starting to get a nice little beak. To really establish this groove being cut in, I'm going to select the three faces that go around the model on the beak section. So I've gone to the face component mode, and I'll hold down shift and select each of these three faces. And when I have them, I'm going to hit extrude the selected component, making sure that keep faces together is turned on. Now I can move this just back into the body of that beak a little bit, and I've got a soft, subtle little groove. If I select this and get the insert edge loop tool and maybe cut two or three more divisions along this to help it hold its form, I can select it in object mode and smooth it, and it'll become rounded out. So I'll go to Mesh, choose Smooth as my final step, and there's my round little chicken beak. Actually, looking at it, I want to move down just a bit. And I've got that little groove running across it. But look at all my history piling up here. Again, I want to go back in, edit, delete all by type history, remove all that history from my scene. So I've got my beak, go to the hypergraph, and let me rename this cube beak. Oops. In fact, I'm actually thinking now that I can actually parent this beak right to the bird body, just like the wings, the comb, and the wattle can be parented to the body as a separate group. I'm going to choose Modify Center Pivot for this group. And my purpose for this is that, if you notice in my reference, the chicken is actually rotated a little bit. So what I'm going to do is grab the Rotate tool with this new group and just rotate it to the side, leaving my feet essentially in place. That's one of the really sort of helpful purposes of groups, is it allows you to select and rotate just what you need. Since I just wanted to move the body and all of its sort of subparts and not the feet, well, I just set up my relationship properly in the hypergraph, and those will be the selections which I can use. Well, last little part here, let me create a base for this, a little sort of rounded base. I'm going to once again go back to my surfaces and my surfaces shelf, and I'll create a sphere, and I'll hit 3, rotate it 90 degrees on the y-axis, and I'm going to flatten this thing out. I'm going to try and scale it proportionally so that it works, and I'll just put my chicken's feet right up on the bottom side of it. And since I don't really need the bottom part to be rounded as well, I'm going to go into my side view. I'm going to right-click on the model and choose Control Vertex, grab a selection of all these bottom vertices, and grab my scale tool. With the green box, I'm just going to scale these together till they're mostly flat. And with the Move tool, I'll just bring them up. Well, this is my base, so I'm going to rename this sphere Base. Move it into the chicken toy group. And there we go. I've got a completed chicken. Move it down to the ground plane, and we're done.